starting the morning, doing a little bit of exploring. Welcome everybody to another daily vlog, a vlog that happens daily, though it's not getting posted daily, as you guys probably know, just because I'm in the middle of nowhere, North Dakota. Right now I'm at the Painted Canyon in North Dakota. It's kind of like the Badlands of New Mexico. It's just not the Badlands of New Mexico. And as we overlook the Painted Canyon, you're not gonna be able to see much with this because I'm using my telephone on the Osmo Mobile. So I can't zoom in like I can on my regular Osmo. I should have probably grabbed that because it's so windy outside. And with that Rode microphone, it would cut out some of the wind. So as we go outside to overlook the canyon, I apologize for the wind. I really do. I can't control the weather. But if you look down into the canyon, sometimes you can see buffalo, wild horses and stuff down there. Don't know if we're going to see anything today. But I wanted to start this little daily vlog inside of the visitor center at the Painted Canyon. So I want to walk you guys around inside the visitor center and see what we could see. So let's do it. Let's head on in. Thing you'll notice is Disney does sponsor this place. Pretty awesome, Disney. They ought to make all this hands-on. It's a little kids' con. Ooh. His hands on here, huh? It's like a velociraptor claw. So, be a big velociraptor. And you got fun pick spots. You can get an original Teddy Roosevelt hat. I wish I used cash because Florida's looking kind of empty almost. They're not really calling for snow today, right? Okay, so I should be able to ease on that way without... Okay, thanks. So she assured me that I should not be hitting any snow, though it feels like it. See, I got my jacket on. It was really quiet in there. I felt out of place, even though the place was empty. I felt like I shouldn't be in there. I had just a weird feeling going through the gift shop. Like I wasn't welcome. But I was the only one in there. Is that North Dakota wildlife?
Well, yeah, I guess he is. He's not very wild, though.
Right top of that long taller weed out there, they're kind of down on this side in behind that lower ridge now. They kind of went down in a valley.
Buffalo or wild horses?
No, just a couple riders.
Oh.
I haven't seen any buffalo or wild horses out here today. So.
Which ridge are you talking about?
No, if you just drop straight down.
Look at that amazing view. Even on a cloudy day, you could still see the red, the whites, so much color. This is the one great thing I like about truck driving. I get a stop sometimes and see some pretty awesome scenery like this, just like that. Look how awesome that is. And look how sharp and pointy this stuff is. Sometimes, like I was saying, inside the building, you can find wild buffalo, wild horses, and other wildlife down in the canyon. Sometimes it's much easier over where those people over there are standing to view over that overlook. And if you just watch, you just have to watch the desert down below. Because you can't really see it because everything blends in. Everything blends in down in that canyon of those hills and everything. But if you look for a little bit of movement here and there, sometimes you'll see that stuff. I don't think we're going to see much today, but let's walk down a little trail just a little ways. Maybe we could see something. Why not? I'm feeling froggy, a little bit froggy. I got 5 days to make it to Seattle. This is awesome because I'm going to be able to do a lot of things this trip. I think I'm going to be able to stop and explore. Check this out. They had dudes back in the Old West. Dude. See, there are paths and trails that lead down into the unknown. They go way all over. There's trails all back in here. And I got my flip-flops on. So let's do some walking. I'm actually not too far from the Montana border. I'll probably be spending the night in Billings, Montana tonight, which is only like 300 miles away from here. So I'll be heading there and I'll probably arrive about 4 o'clock. So I'm not in a big rush. I'm just not in a big rush. I could actually stop and enjoy some of the sights, the sounds, the smells of North Dakota today. Hopefully no trips or no falls, because look how steep this is. That is a long way down. There's a trail this way, so let's mosey on down that trail. And it goes 4 miles into the canyon. It probably would not be a bad idea for me to probably invest and a little bit of hiking shoes for when I can do things like this, just because these down here are not meant for hiking. These are my Florida shoes. I need some Painted Canyon shoes. Kind of like a deer trail. It's kept up pretty nice. Now there's numerous trails all throughout the Teddy Roosevelt State Park system here. This is just one of them. This is the fat truck driver trail. Because that's the trail for me. Florida, we do have trail systems, especially in the Ocala Forest, but nothing like this. We don't have hills and mountains and valleys and painted canyons like they do in other states. Now's the time I wish I had purchased a Segway Mini. Growing up near Yosemite National Park and the Lake Tahoe area and the whole 395 corridor out in California, this reminds me a lot of it, the way the trail systems are. Look at this. Nice. Well, we started way up there. Came quite a ways, but I'm going to continue going. I need the exercise. I came to a fork in the road. I could go that way right there, or I could end up going that way right there. Don't know which way to go. There's a sign here. It says the same thing. I can go that way or I can go that way. I don't know which way to go. Let's go this way. We're gonna go this way. I hope I made the right decision. Check out the erosion down here. And it's only gonna get worse as the snow starts to come. Yeah, the trail is starting to get a little bit rough. The colors kind of seem to pop and kind of match the scenery. You get the plant life because it's fall, so all the plants are changing colors. You get the beautiful light colored green yellows, the darker greens. And then you get all these painted cliffs. It's like a piece of art. It's a piece of art that nature created. This is definitely a photographer's paradise. If you're ever out here in the middle of North Dakota on I-90, I'm on 94 because I'm on the north part of North Dakota. And if you're ever going out this way, heading towards Montana and stuff, the Teddy Roosevelt Park system and the Painted Canyons is a pretty amazing place. I suggest anybody driving by, stop, enjoy. I would say smell the roses, but here, the best you could do is smell the sagebrush. All right, everybody, I'm gonna head back to the truck and today's daily vlog, the vlog that happens daily, trying to keep the video short just because if I do find a Wi-Fi hotspot somewhere, it's not gonna take hours and hours and hours to upload them because a lot of the Wi-Fi out here in the West is extremely slow. So if I keep the video short, if I hit a Wi-Fi hotspot, I should be able to upload them. So that's my plan anyway. So please remember to like, comment, share, subscribe, and I will talk to you all on the next one from the Painted Canyon in North Dakota. We'll talk to y'all later. Peace, everybody.